Please be seated. Whether you are watching online, on cable TV, or you're here at the excellent AC Marriott Hotel in Kingston, welcome to the 12th staging of the Jamaica Poetry Festival 2022. I am your host, Simone Absalom Gale. The Jamaica Poetry Festival was conceived in 2011 as part of Jamaica's 50th anniversary celebrations with the kind support of the Jamaica Cultural Development Commission, JCDC. It has now grown from strength to strength, evolving into an internationally recognized poetry festival with remarkable global impact and appeal. For 9 years, JPF was physically staged at the Louise Bennett Garden Theater, and in 2020 and 2021, it went virtual as a result of the global pandemic, as we all know. This year, we are blended with both a physical and virtual audience. There are several components to JPF. There is the Creative Arts Workshop, the Lifetime Achievement Awards for Excellence in the Literary Arts, and the Award of Honor for Outstanding Contribution to Jamaica Music and Culture. There is also the Feast of Poetry Showcase, which is what this evening is basically about. This year, we saw a dinner being added to the list of offerings, the proceeds of which will be in aid of the deaf community. And this year, there will be a special gate prize for a lucky winner, a weekend for two, courtesy of Sandals Resort International. Good stuff. I do believe that the global pandemic has also made it possible for us to not only impact and influence cultures with our creativity and our ways of thinking, with our literary and musical art forms, but also with our creative writing. So if you missed this year's workshop, please try not to miss the next one next year. So you're watching the live broadcast, for those who are watching online and on cable television, of the Jamaica Poetry Festival, and we are broadcasting live from the AC Marriott Hotel in New Kingston, Jamaica. I know you all didn't come here physically to hear me speak fluently or to see how beautiful I look. Special thanks to OMG Jewelry for my neck pieces. I know you saw me broadcasting a bit of it earlier. All right, so we're going to be kicking off the 12th staging of the Jamaica Poetry Festival. And you know that JPF is all about clean, intelligent, fun for the entire family and community, which is our collective responsibility. Calvin Mitchell, I welcome the rhythmic sound of the drum, and I call on him to share his talent with us. Calvin?
Oh, if I didn't even... Calvin, you snoop up on me. And I'm never see him now.
All right, kick it off, kick it off.
Thank you.
don't go nowhere. We're gone so quick.
Oh, let me get this.
No, play a little piece again for me there. Play a little piece again. Give him a round of applause. I'm sure when he was playing, we felt a little bit of our ancestors coming into the building. And, you know, I felt like doing a little, you know. You know what I imagined? You remember when they'd say there are stories of slaves using drums to communicate from one plantation to the other. And a part of his piece, I could sense one drum speaking to the other. Life.
Yes, Calvin. Yeah, man. Thank you. So we're going to be moving on. Thank you so much. I might call you back up here again to give us another piece. So. talented gentlemen. So we're going to be getting a message from JN Group by Mr. Roland Watson Grant. He is the Chief Creative Specialist at the Creative Unit and a member of the JN Group. He's also a Jamaican-born award-winning novelist, travel writer, and screenwriter. Welcome. Looking good? Oh, you can just... You can borrow my mic. You mind?
Okay, just come to the...
Good afternoon, everyone. Good evening, everyone. I'm happy that my alter ego is here today as travel writer, etc. Simply because that is one of the things that is close to my heart. But one of the other roles I play, as I greet you for Jamaica National, one of the other roles I play, as some of you might know, who are parents, that when you have a 10-year-old, what you get to do is to do primary or prep school all over again. I find that as an opportunity because recently when my son was preparing for prep, for PEP, I was able to look over once again at the life of Sam Sharp. And I realized that Sam Sharp was actually going to do peaceful protest. So his weapons of war were words. And one of his things that were forged in the fires of words was the ability to also speak those to his fellow Africans to let them know exactly what the plan was going to be. Of course, the rest is history. We know that the Christmas Rebellion was one of the things that sparked movements all over, and today we are actually a part of the legacy of the freedom and the independence that Sam Sharp did. So Jamaica National is happy once again to be a part of this event, and we look forward to staging this and being a part of this yet another year. Thank you.
Thanks again to JN. All right, now we're going to be welcoming Miss Samoya Banton, poet and humanitarian. Samoya has been busy not only writing poems, but she has also been helping those in her community. They say poetry nurtures, and Samoya Banton is proof. Make her welcome, everyone. Samoya. You're gonna need it. Can I get some help on stage to get Samoya set up a little bit? Just bear with us. So while they set up Samoya, let's fast in a business. Come over here. So while she'd like the podium, but while they... let's go. Sir. Hi. You're looking good.
Thank you. You too.
All right. Thank you. Let's tell the audience a little bit about you. Where are you from?
I'm from St. Elizabeth.
St. Best in the building. Anybody else from St. Best in the building? All right. Samoya, you're still a student, right?
Yes.
Which school do you attend?
I attend the Hampton School for Girls.
All right, so some Hampton, all right, me go Mergrove. Mergrove High School is my thing. Okay, all right, calm down. Okay, so it's very unusual for a teenager to be so settled in her purpose in life so early, right? How did you start doing poetry?
One day I was in a very dark period of my life. I felt like I didn't fit in with my peers. And I sat down and I started writing. and I just the words just continued to flow and flow. I think I was about 14 at the time, and ever since then I've just continued writing. I realized that I think I'm pretty decent at it, so since I was 14.
That's how it starts a lot of the time. It starts with a seed inside of us, and then you just let it grow. You know what I mean? Raw talent being honed into an exceptional, exceptional young lady. All right. Share your talent with us, Samoya.
Good evening, everyone. This first poem is entitled Crime. Are we just fake mad? On social media acting big and bad, but won't protest for the rights? Won't put up a real fight? Will we just not care until the next woman disappears? Are we gonna demand justice one day and then forget about it the next? I'm pleading to our people, stop the glorification of guns. The matic won't be so appealing when mommy's on the receiving end. Everybody's mad for a day. Oh no, a woman is killed. Say her name. Young, sweet Donnelly. I hope her fate isn't the same as Jasmine Dean. One day we're loud, and then not a sound. Then forgotten again like she didn't exist. Where's the real change? I won't stand for this. Hear her father, her mother, their cries getting louder, while society still not a sound. Men and women, please, I'm begging, but not as hard as the woman whose throat was cut last night, because her pleas weren't heard while she was brutalized. She was terrorized. She was afraid and she was alone. I'm tired of wondering who will be next. Is it me? Aren't you tired of wondering? Aren't you tired of wondering who will be next? This next poem is entitled Dark. It was one of the first ones I had originally written. Scared of the dark, the shadows lurking underneath. Don't make a sound. Not one peep. Why is the dark so scary? Is it the fear of the unknown? Is it the fear of never truly being alone? Is it the secrets that lie underneath? Is it a chilling fear, not knowing what's truly there? Is it the shadows that call out to you? Are you scared? Do you feel like screaming, but no one can hear? Is your blood running cold? Are you feeling unrest in your soul? Do you wanna cry? Is no one watching? Is the fear creeping up on you, but you can't stop it? No one's coming, you're better off dead. Worthless, unwanted, are the voices taunting your head? Poor little girl. No one's coming for you. No one's crying for you. They don't want you. Is it snarling and growling, yelling and howling? No escape. No sympathy. Poor little girl. Always wanting to fit in. How does it feel knowing that you're locked in? This last poem is entitled Pretty Black Girl. People often say, you're a pretty black girl. Man, you're pretty for a black girl. But what does that mean? Does it mean that dark-skinned girls are not usually beautiful? Oftentimes not meeting society's beauty standards? Why is it? Why is it? Why is it that when you compliment or lose, the word black is attached? So, here's to all the black girls. We are majestic.
and graceful swans, not the ugly ducklings they want us to believe we are. We are made in his image and have the spirit and the courage of our ancestors. So black queens, rise. Black queens, rise. They want to put women against each other, pushing this narrative of brown versus black, where brown signifies beauty, class, and grace, and black is seen as loud, malicious, and ugly. But need I remind you that no matter the color of your skin, you are divine, so love and embrace the skin that is thine. So black queens, rise. Black queens, rise. I'm so sick and tired of black women being judged for the color of their skin and texture of their hair. So excuse me if I can't accept your compliment of me being a pretty black girl. I'm sorry if my skin doesn't meet what's considered your beauty standards. I'm sorry if my skin doesn't meet what's considered your beauty standards. I feel sorry for you that you see beauty as only skin deep. I pity you for your ignorance, because I see all shades of black as beautiful. So black queens, rise. Black queens, rise. Black queens, rise.
Sorry.
Can you hear me? Good.
We want to welcome another woman who is no stranger to Jamaican poetry, the Jamaican landscape. Her poems are ones that provide thoughtfulness, like Samoya's. Let's welcome Kai Falconer to the stage. Kai? Hi, Kai.
Good night, everybody. All right, I will be doing three pieces today, and I will start with a piece entitled More. Maybe we can let go of the notion of having to be this or that and realize that just being is perfect. See, I spent years waiting for others to accept, but it was this road to self-acceptance which led to my present living in love and harmony concept. I had to cleanse the mind of the toxic, become empty to give space and embrace this universe ingredient, realized I had been so system obedient. Reflection, now revealing, fear-based believing, long-buried feelings and no attention to healing. I wasted so much time accepting other people's vision, hiding my own with dark tint glasses with my own non-confrontational decision. But I realized in order to reconstruct this mission I envisioned, I had to tear down some of these freedom-killing traditions. I can no longer be held hostage by public illusion. I've been put into these boxes that I never quite fit into. I got out, I stepped out so fearful that it was a sin to call me a sinner. And I will continue to question you. My problem is not your belief system, but your belief that arbitrary self-separation from your belief system has not made others a victim. Sick of the compromising and dehumanizing, being led to feel mistaken, creative thinking and the concept of difference for granted taken, must be kept second-guess-making, must be kept underestimating self-institutions. Soon I'll no longer be able to lift these ankles with these shackles, driven by the material, by the mold for which mass perspective of success is sold. Yet, I can still hear the snickering when I say how vast we are, that there is so much more to be told. Thank you. So I'll move on to another piece, and this one is entitled Trust. It's actually a version of my piece entitled Trust. I've shortened it just a bit. The first day I met him wasn't the first day of class, but it was the first day I was introduced to his subject matter. Eager to learn, every day I was present. Not as concerned with the attention-grabbing textbook wrapper as I was with the eclectic content this subject's textbook had to offer. I wrote pages to the question of him. Turns out those pages were written with some under-the-influence pen. I was so sure I got it, but then it came back from the teacher, all marked up with X's, with suggestions to omit certain words like commit. Can't trust myself, my judgment anymore. This is the kind of that makes me not trust anymore. I see snapshots when I blink of who I was once was when, that has been so long since. This is the kind of that makes me not trust anymore. Instead of rewriting my answer, patching and padding characters, making up for paragraphs that had through them red ink, forcing me to rethink concepts like happiness and compromise and how not to get only one of those to monopolize. I rolled the paper up and put a band around it, and I tucked it neatly into my knapsack compartment with the tag lessons on it. Trust that this distrust of myself is sincere. This is why I keep it safe for when or where I decide to love again boundlessly and bare. Not allowing tear stains to smudge the blessing, risking the integrity of this graded paper and lesson. Life, my teacher, insisted I speak with her. She was afraid I was gonna let this grade make me bitter. I looked over my shoulder and I softly confided in her that I did feel like a failure or a quitter. How do I accept that even if I reread the textbook, I couldn't have done any better? I desperately awaited words of comfort. But by the time I glanced up, life had continued onward. She had already turned on the projector, showing upcoming terrain and gear manuals for future lovers, case studies demonstrating what desires to never let my baby girl put above hers, long buried experiences of my past that taught to put aside my interests for what other people want. I thought to make it through love, there had to be some price, and for me, that price had been self-sacrifice. Life said it was time for my next assignment. She said I needed a new pen for this one and some solitary confinement. She said, get your notepad and ask it for what you need. Ask your soul what it needs to feed on, to breathe. She said there would be no grade for this one, only one condition. I was not allowed to doodle anywhere in my notepad self-caricatures of who I thought he wanted and make up unrealistic characters. I found an empty space with ceiling-to-floor mirrors sat in the most distant corner, leaned back, one foot bent, the other stretched out, grabbed my notepad and pen, took a deep breath, and began. I need you to laugh with me. I need you to believe in me more than I believe in myself. I need you to understand the endless possibility of synchrony and growth for us both. I need you to listen. I need you to appreciate the magnitude of our solitude. I need you to love me and to not fear vulnerability. To be honest and open with yourself and to be willing to be seen honestly and openly. I need you to know what I bring and objectively evaluate whether you have what it takes to truly be my king. What kind of father will you be? Do we value enough of the same, and for everything else, can you trust me to take blame? I need you to be endless along. I need you to be selfless along with me, to respect and cherish me. Can we share power equally? Do you love truth like I love truth? Give me long dates for us to really communicate. Do you know who you are and who you are not? Give me confidence that you know true courage, that you're not afraid to be yourself every day, not just when it's trendy or cool to be that way. Maybe you can even understand my contradictory need to be free, but for you to still protect me. Give me safety. Give me confidence that I can love you safely, that I can trust you safely, that I can trust myself again. All right, and the last piece is entitled Survival. In the sky, we made our vows to no longer be tippy-toed and tight-lipped. Looking over at your hands holding on to mine, we said our final goodbyes to the no offense intending and the constant mending. What came next was years of awkward tugging of parachute strings. Awkward to pull these strings, you see, because for years our hands were still intertwined, sometimes unknowingly. Still floating, connected emotionally and mentally, still floating, now hungry, thirsty, and homesick. Still trying to figure out their arithmetic that brings me home, where I can finally detach from a public character, when my inner being is at peace. When I'm around everything that inspires me, when I feel real belonging and I finally find my place where I'm safe. Finally, the clouds dissipate and I realize I can see the ground right in front of my face, so I brace. Because it's been 3 years suspended in space, feet buckling because I have not yet rebuilt trust in them. Scared, but I keep my poker face. No longer within the boundaries of all the expectations. Now floating within my own boundaries of my own parachute. Warm hues of gold and red light surrounded me as the sun sets ever so beautifully. The universe has finally summoned me. There it is, that dreaded impact of a new reality. I survived. I'm not dead, she said. Thank you so much.
Ladies and gentlemen, Kai Falconer. Words. That evoke thoughtfulness. Words that took you to a place in your imagination. The persons that connected to those words would understand when I say, it make you want all our meds. You know what I'm saying? All right. Now, up next, we have a special guest. This individual made a significant contribution to the Jamaican landscape. He was a founding member of KLAS FM and Cool 97 FM. Did I say that the way they would say it on radio? Cool 97 FM. He also made significant contributions to the lives of people with disabilities in Jamaica. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome Patrick Lafayette. He's with us on screen.
Hello, everyone. I wish I could be in Jamaica right now with all of you. I want to thank YAYA. I want to thank Ja.
Greetings, my name is Patrick Lafayette, and I'd like to express my most profound honor to be a part of the 12th Annual Jamaica Poetry Festival for 2022. On February 14 of this year, the Disabilities Act became a reality in Jamaica. The passing of this law is truly a milestone in the lives of persons with disabilities. As a member of this community, I've been a longtime advocate for access, and most especially for the hearing impaired community. At present, a deaf person is unable to access the emergency 119 service, but with the support of my brother Yasus Afari, it is the hope that we can assist in making this hope a reality. I'd like to present to you a poem in tribute to our children, the children across the world in general, and our children in Jamaica in particular. This is from the poet N.E. Watt, and it is called Give a Damn.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was Mr. Patrick Lafayette, and he had one main message. Can you guess what it was? Anybody? Don't say it all at once now. He's just saying that we should care. I'm saying it in another way. All right, we're moving on to our next guest, Mr. George Elliot Clarke. He's a man who has 17 collections of poetry, 2 novels, and 4 works in drama and opera. He was Poet Laureate of Toronto and a Canadian Parliamentary Poet Laureate, Jamaica Poetry Festival 2022 welcomes Mr. George Elliot Clarke. He'll also be on our screens.
Hello, everyone. I wish I could be in Jamaica right now with all of you. I want to thank YA-YA, I want to thank Ja for the invitation to be part of this poetry festival. And I will be reading a poem. I should also say I am George Elliot Clarke, former Poet Laureate of Canada. My poem that I'll be reading is entitled The Gospel of X. And X is Jesus, but this is a different viewpoint. And I hope that no one will be offended by some of the liberties that I take, given that the poem is in X's voice. The Gospel of X. I am sure my father is God, that God is my father. I was born of milk, not blood. I came to light outside my mother's flesh before an audience of dazzled cattle, attentive lambs, my legs kicked at the air. A newborn as incarnate as my mama's womb, truly I was as infallible as any infant. The man I call Pappy, this carpenter who can fashion no poem, hide us down to Egypt as half-caste outcasts, Jews in a romance province. The stories told that a special star, a triangular moon like a diamond blazing, navigated our way, away from the blood-hungering belly of a satrap, nervous of prophecies, who dispatched legions to hack to pieces a baby male population. Some old timers never hesitate to call my birth a curse, one entailing the hurried, sudden massacre by provincial fiat of their boys, squalling infants and pissing toddlers. They whisper, too, that Pappy felt tricked by Mum, that my paternity is suspect, but the white-haired midwife's gossip always set right, when somehow at my side, a coconut palm just drooped down as my mother wept and gave Pappy its fat and milk. Among the Egyptians, though sepia and copper and ivory people, much was made of my yellow ochre complexion, gold plated like the sun, but also of Pappy's clay skin and lava blood, and of Mum, her eyes large with light, a pretty street Cleopatra, so sang the papyrus jongleur, those high-maintenance poets, so easily loosened up by liquor, who were capable of quaffing their own vomit. They are eternal proof that intelligence and intoxication prompt ridiculous antics. Egypt says she invented eternity. Verily, I saw time driven away, expelled into darkness, dragging all light with it into exile. In Egypt, we were historic immigrants and potential penitents and converts, or so their antique priests dreamt, in our house of old wood, palm wine, and music lit up our gaudy kinship. Yet, despite even fat bastard in the jug, Pappy was often moody. Neighbors whispered he was as gullible as a carpenter in a lawyer's office, given his blatant betrayal by Mum. Some nights, Pappy sat brown and stocky in our doorway, sat as huge as a side of beef sliced off in an abattoir, and both Mum and me kept aloof as we watched him scrutinize stars and then study the dirt at his feet. When I turned 12, Pappy turned us back to Jerusalem, and I sat in ink-stained wooden desks, auditing preachers and philosophes who were also perfect panderers and fakes. They spoke so lusciously they could almost sell a whore to God. Truly, they were poshly poetic, but their prayers rhymed finely with prophet, P-R-O-F-I-T. When I bandied scripture with them, reversing their hypotheses, hypocrisies, with their own verses, I frightened them half to death, and they'd whine, "Who the hell you think you are, an apprentice messiah?" Exegesis takes smart techniques, metaphysics that nicks quizzes. Pappy'd worry when these hyenas marred me, and so to please him, I became as awfully silent as God. Even so, Pappy's hammer words forged a ringing model for my own. When I reached 30, I put away my childish rectitude, my facile virtue, and put myself out to temptation. I drifted out into the desert. I stumbled over the dusty bodies of a Roman executed, rotting face down in the dirt, though the night's blackness was alive with throbbing stars. I envisioned incarnate that race of bliss women, and I was shaken. My cold, unshared bed had never warmed to a punk out to skunk some spunk, or a lady eager to get right down and damn indecent, as the tavern poets recite. Even though my buddy swore you gotta wallow holy in smut, tap philosophy from the way up behind bobs and jumps, my mates prodded me to swive, to copulate soon and often. Magdalena is the choicest sweet, her long legs angled to a point of wet baptism. Her untidy nudity, her unparalleled hips must be paralyzing. Her ankles, copper jewelry, a gold promise at night, the promise of her like toffee, earth-brown flavor, a hickory scent, the prophecy of a hell of a heavenly time. Especially should I take title to her, muster, master her tawny lust, and brand her my wife. And I do want a womb to buckle rod and suckle child, and end my fretless fretting over salvation. Death, this sad disease, should not exist. In the desert, these visions tore at me. I feel this earth is fastened to a tyrant sun, so saints go to dust and shrouds, distress ain't alien to this orbit. There is never enough virtue, no matter how plentiful the swords. I saw a whole seabed of stars, hellish cities lit up like Sodom, awaiting my soothing governance. I also saw churches full of hunger and ranked, Bible-dark faces desperate to know my pleasure. In the desert, these visions tore at me. I decided to forge my own stride. I'd sourly brood and go about scattering sunlight wisdom like melted butter and honey, and deliver the promise of fish to anxious cooks. And at that fiesta at Cana, I blushed water into wine, so perfumes acquired operatic pungency, and the usually hangdog Moors plunged their faces into cups, and everyone partayed so heartily, got so liquored up and fat with cake, there was nothing to do but rise and clonk, clonk home. Back in Jerusalem, I bullwhipped bullshitters out the temple, and at every jaw's corner, my question mark struck at naysayers like sickles scything down wheat. Multitudes thronged. I touched cripples, and they tossed away canes and crutches. One dead guy, Lazarus, rode to Mary de Magdala, danced right up out his grave, not only sprightly, but melodramatically 20 years younger. I eschewed adulation, but sought an audience. What preacher don't want a church? Soon I attracted disciples, a dozen, and the crowds could have, with a nod from me and some miracle of charity, healing the dead, fattening the hungry, conceived themselves an army, and menaced the civic powers. I set a direction for poverty and my nominal coterie, and I went about virulently penniless, yet fame won us feasts and flowers. Those I saved from sick beds and cemeteries celebrated us with gold. Judas warned, worship is a prison. I told the masses, begged them to give the Caesar all he demands, every tribute, every hosanna, and I never diverted a dime from plutocrats. I even harried the poor to pay their taxes. Still, Rome got nervous, my critics got jealous, satanically envious, and now I am where I am. Wine drills me like a knife. Peter, that gruff saint, breaks a hunk of bread, handsome to stave off our allotted rotting. No faith is to be put in Judas, who swears religion is poetry clarified as law. He has his backers among the Pharisees, so politically brutal, personally dreary, physically dirty, and stylistically dull. But the price of their praise is his sullen, silvery treason. Tomorrow, I'll face a rodent-hearted, rat-eyed impresario, a sub-Caesar who'll schedule my conspicuous execution, a dandy crucifixion. He'll spread blood over his throne, splash it all over his crown. I go now to my garden danger, Gethsemane. Judas slithered toward me. His kiss was maliciously delicious. When Rome's paid thugs, swords glittering wildly in moonlight, swarmed to imprison me, Peter plied in all business anger, locked one copper's ear, who yelled with the shock and pain of it all. The crimson rupture also splattered his confrere legionnaires. I calmed the chaos, erased the blood squirting from the injured cop's head, repaired his ear, but Peter took advantage of the lull and fled. It was one unsatisfactory victory. Once one for strutting, Peter turns now the stuttering saint. His actions and retractions prefigure Hamlet. Verily, history is the sport of kings and the tragedy of subjects. Against this deep violet sky, I want to know I am before I become I was. The world creeps on in its bloody course. Nobody feels anything quite painless. Actually, I would gladly trade places with the grave.
Ladies and gentlemen, those were the words of Mr. George Elliot Clarke. Those are such beautiful words. All right, so the event organizers obviously are giving us a feast of poetry tonight, from one poetry laureate to another. He's a man who was awarded the Order of Merit and the first Jamaican to be appointed a poet laureate since independence. Welcome, Professor Mervyn Morris. Professor Morris. Whoop, give him some.
Peeling orange. They used to say, you peel the orange perfect and you get new clothes. But when my father tried to teach me slide the knife up to the safeguard thumb, I moved the weapon like a saw in my hand and the damn rind break. And if you have the time, you can come see me in my old clothes. Peeling. The pond. There was this pond in the village, and little boys he heard till he was sick were not allowed too near. Unfathomable pool, they said, that swallowed men and animals just so, and in its depths, old people said, swam gallywasps and nameless horrors. Bright boys kept away. Though drawn so hard by prohibitions, the small boy, fixed in fear, kept off till one wet summer, grass growing lush, paths muddy, slippery, he found himself there at the fabled edge. The brooding pond was dark. Sudden, escaping cloud, the sun came bright. And shimmering in guilt, he saw his own face peering from the pool. Toasting a muse. One man who came to dinner wouldn't eat, just focused on his hostess' instant, eloquent devotion. He'd stand and say, as if proposing a toast, "I speak this in your honor, ma'am, you are so beautiful." Then chant some passionate verse and sit and drink some more until the spirit moved in him again, then stand and say, "You are so beautiful," etc., and do another item. Funny fellow, poet, mad as hell. I been there, sort of. For in that ambience, I too was smitten by what seemed to me unusual radiance, beauty of spirit lighting up the place. But I kept quiet about it, made small talk, stayed sober, and enjoyed the food. Casanova. Flaunting his gym-toned pectorals, washboard stomach, fashion-conscious locks, he works the image of philanderer, every woman's fantasy or threat. But something tremulous inside his gravelly baritone exposed a small boy quivering in the dark, his mother dead, his father gone away, groping for explanations. North Coast Hotel. The lovely pregnant lady leaning on the disco bar lets dance hall flow through her. An elegant black patrician breaking out before her man, a chunky brother decorously sipping wine, while she is moving like a native to the bass, teaching the child dance hall. togetherness, one. Lying in the dark together, we, in wordless dialogue, defined community. Two, you switched the light on to inspect an alien remark, and now your body stutters. No more lying in the dark. Tried for the murder of his common law wife, trombonist Don Drummond was found guilty but insane and committed to the mental asylum. Valley Prince for Dundee. Me one, way out in the crowd, I blow the sounds, the pain, but not a soul would come inside my world or tell me how it's true. I love a melancholy baby, sweet with fire in her belly, and like a spite, the woman turn a whore. Cool and smooth around the beat, she wake the note inside me, and I blow me mine. Inside here, me one in the crowd again, and plenty people want me blow it straight, but straight is not the way my world don't go, so that is lie. When you give me back my trombone, man, it's time to blow me mine. Love is a giving and a measured taking, amputation, recreating, everlasting interface, a prison and an open space, a teasing glimpse of holy grail, a generator that can fail, the naked jugular, the knife, the torsion balance in my life. Ground Nation for Cedric Brooks. Cedric Brooks, a Rastafarian musician. Out of that pain, that bondage, heavy, heavy sounds, our brother's weary march, our shackled trip. A joyful horn takes off to freedom time, remembered and foretold. Release, I brother, let me go, let my people go home to Ethiopia in the mind. For consciousness. Old plantation wither, factory closed down, brothers of the country raising cane in town. And now them in the city sweating blood, them fine is just like is just the same just like the same system them mean to left behind. But agents of the owners them is hard and out of sight. Plenty bush I don't ride us, and some don't think them white. In the new plantation story, first thing that have to know is who and who to tackle when the call to battle blow. Cabal. Them beg him till them sick and tired. Him wouldn't sign him name to what the most of them want lick the opposition with. Him say, same knife, stick sheep, sick goat, and walk out of the room. The big man bust a funny laugh. Nobody never talked to him like that. Him say, trust me, idiot must learn. So first of all, we kick the idiot out the group. And then we start the rumor saying, bawl for mercy when we check the books again. You never know him teeth? Yes, man. Teeth like puss unless you're washing him. And now that him exposed, pure grief to get another job. Him should have bow. Me scratch your back, you scratch mine. But if you turn traitor, you must pay. Damn fool. The idiot boy was trying to block the road. We move him out the way. Obit. To pay the rent while working on his novel, he got a job in journalism. He jumped into a swirl of bars and drunks and prostitutes, pastors, area leaders, Christians, beggars, politicians, pimps. Baby mothers whispered good material for the novel, and now and then a hint of breaking news. He grappled with the fiction, page by page, shaping the manuscript, honoring our people and the craft. The book was nearly ready when he died. But drive-by shootings, fire bombings, headless corpses, diabolic duns had made him want to do some more on evil pullulating in the mix. A birthday poem. Pile Jankro, circling year after year, habitually conveys congratulations dead on time. Each year it wheezes, hovering, happy birthday, you decline hereafter, everything decays. Supernal mockery presents that gliding messenger on time each year, in pantomime of blessing, rhyme malevolence of joy before our wasting innocence. The day my father died, I could not cry. My mother cried, not I. His face on the pillow in the dim light wrote mourning to me, black and white. We saw him struggle, stiffen, relax. The face fell empty, dead as wax. I had read of death, but never seen. My father's face, I swear, was not serene. Topple that lie, however appealing. That face was absence of all feeling. My mother's tears were my tears. Each sob shook me. The pain of death is living. The dead are free. For me, my father's death was mother's sorrow. That day was her day. Loss was tomorrow. Soprano. They say she sang her heart out day before she died. Truth is, she sang her heart out time after time, just like the day before she soared into another life, still singing heaven. Granny. When Granny died, I stumbled in and out her place, remembering banana porridge, fumbling her dog-eared Bible, faded bedspread, musty cushions, hugging memories of her love. From the overflowing funeral, this fingered program is a talisman I carry everywhere. Love is with me still. Epiphany. Saying goodbye on the phone, our cancer patient seemed a bit subdued, till near the airport, suddenly, she turned to her beloved in delight. Look, I heard her say, a rainbow, look. Checking out, I slammed the door. Dear, are you positive there's nothing left? Well, no, something remains, I'm sure of that. Some vestige of our lives in this bare flat will linger. Some impulse will outlive our going, recycled in the flow of being. We never leave. We always have to go. A chant against death. Say family, say friends, say wife, say love, say life, say learning, laughter, sunlight, rain. Say cycle, circle, music, memory. say night and day, say sun and moon, say see you soon.
We have to take care of our elderly, right? We have to take care of the treasures of our islands while they are here and alive. Thank you so much for sharing your creative words, your life work with us, Professor. Each of those poems were different topics, different time periods of someone's life. Right to make things right. If you're not right, you're wrong. Let us all write. Whenever I hear those words of Professor Morris, I always want to write. His words, his work encourages us. It helps us to understand that we all have a poet within us. So you can write to make things right. And if you're not right after tonight, you're wrong. All right. Every song, though, is a poem, right? It's a poem set to music. Poetry nurtures the artistic, creative poetry of life. Our next performer is a Jamaican pianist, percussionist, and educator who was musical director of the National Dance Theatre Company for 45 years. Let's welcome a woman who has contributed so much to Jamaica's musical and literary art form and Jamaica Poetry Festival 2022 Lifetime Achievement Awardee, Marjorie Whylie OD. Ms. Whylie, another treasure of Jamaica. This one. Continue clapping, make her welcome. Let me ensure that she gets safely up to the...
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, give her a round of applause. Round of applause. One of our national treasures. I mean, she went and got the spirit of Louise Bennett Coverley in the building. Evening time, work is over now, it's evening time. They walk on mountain, they walk on mountainside, make me go to make a bandy way. What? Poetry in music, ladies and gentlemen. So there's only one word I'd like to use. Two? There's only one word we would like to, yes, describe this performance. Legendary. It was legendary. We're going to invite you back onto the stage, if you would be so kind. She has to come around that way, you see, because you have to take her around that. Or would you want her to stand right there? Okay, you can stand. All right. So, on behalf of the Jamaican people and the Jamaica Poetry Festival at 2022, we'd like to bestow upon you this Lifetime Achievement Award. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, Marjorie Whylie. If you're just joining us online or on the cable TV, Miss Whylie was the musical director of the National Dance Theatre Company for 45 years. Thank you very much for your service to the country and your fellow Jamaicans. Thank you. Now we have come to the halfway point of the 12th staging of the Jamaica Poetry Festival. Are you having a good time? Give me a little hand. Okay. All right, so earlier today we had the creative writing workshop, we had craft displays, and we had the inaugural staging of the Jamaica 60th anniversary dinner, Voice to the Voiceless, proceeds of which will support the deaf community. Before we go to the break, though, we call on stage Dr. Christine Hendricks, who is Executive Director at Jamaica Council for Persons with Disabilities, and they will be presented with a check by Yassos. Yassos? Oh, he's sending a representative. So, the check is being presented by Seniacom Edutainment. The Voice for the Voiceless dinner was organized to support members of the disabled community. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for this moment. And members of the community, they have been helping out with this event by ensuring that their members are understanding and are able to view what's going on. Thank you very much. And thank you to Seniacom Edutainment. All right. So, you see, poetry and humanitarianism often go together. So, we're full of belly, we're full in a spirit, and we're full in a soul, all right? So, we have to let you digest and make some more space for what we have to deliver in the next half of the show. I also want to remind you that there is a special gate prize for a weekend for two, courtesy of Sandals. All right, so we're going to go to a little break. And while we break, we're going to be talking to Jasmine Jazzy Headley. Is she here? So,
Jasmine.
Oh, there she is. Miss Jasmine in her princess dress. Welcome, welcome. So, gonna take a little intermission here. Hi, Jasmine.
Hi.
No, stand this side so we can see you in your dress. So Jasmine Jazzy Headley is an 8-year-old Canadian pop artist, writer, actor.
9 years old.
Oh, you're 9 now. Oh, sorry. One more year. Sorry. She's 9. My apologies, ma'am. So, but she's done so much so far in her life, right? She is a pop artist. Am I right? I want to make sure that I'm getting it. Okay. Uh-huh. And you're a writer, actor. And we're going to ask her a few more questions about, you know, her life, herself, before she performs for us. So how did you get involved in entertainment? Come, wait, let me get you. Maybe you can. Oh, okay, okay. Yes, how did you get involved in acting and stuff?
Well, I started singing when I was 3 because I grew up listening to Michael Jackson, Katy Perry, Pentatonix. So I ended up wanting to sing.
Mm-hmm.
So my parents, during COVID, they decided she has a talent, we're gonna help her continue this talent. So that's when they got me a singing coach. And during COVID, my brother was acting. His name is Elijah, so I wanted to act too.
All right, so I wonder why they thought you'd be good at it. Tell me a little bit about your character. Was it because they give a lot of trouble?
No.
Were you performing for all your family members all the time?
Yes, for like school events. When I got my hair done, I would have to sing for my hairdresser.
All right, so it was coming out. So tell me a little bit about your stage career, though. How's that going?
What do you mean by like stage career?
Because I'm reading that you're a pop artist, so what's that about? What kind of song and what kind of music, and how did you get involved in that part, the singing part?
When I was 3, I grew up listening to music, and during COVID, me and my parents, we got more into my singing.
So you've been singing all over now?
Yeah.
So how's that going? Are you enjoying that part of your career?
Yeah, I got to sing at school events, family events.
All right, so are you planning to do anything for us? Can we hear a little bit of your singing? Do you mind?
I'm going to sing Jimmy Cliff, I Can See Clearly Now.
Wow, Jimmy Cliff. All right, I leave you to it. Let me just leave her to it right here. All right.
Sunshiny day. It's gonna be a bright, 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 bright sunshiny day. I think I can make it now, the pain is gone. All of the bad feelings have disappeared. There is that rainbow I've been praying for. It's gonna be a bright, 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 bright sunshiny day. Look all around, there's nothing but blue skies. Look straight ahead, there's nothing but blue skies. I can see clearly now the rain.
I can see all obstacles in my way. There is that rainbow I've been praying for. It's gonna be a bright, 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 bright sunshiny day. It's gonna be a bright, 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 bright sunshiny day. It's gonna be a bright, 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 bright sunshiny day. It's gonna be a bright, 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 bright sunshiny day.
Be careful, your dresses, you know. Beautiful dress, beautiful singing, wonderful song.
All right, at this point, we're going to be calling Mr. Lance Thomas of Sun Coast Beach Club to come up to the stage and give a presentation.
Greetings all. I think we're all having a great time here. Fabulous, isn't it? This is presenting arts on this stage, at this level of excellence is certainly unprecedented, and I really give it up to Senyacom for delivering this kind of production. Okay, so rooted in its use of the aesthetic and rhythmic qualities of language to communicate, poetry is foundational to the entire spectrum of the creative arts. We salute the Jamaica Poetry Festival in its 12th year. Yeah, this is one dozen. Give it up for the Poetry Festival. We salute this festival for its exceptional work in promoting an art form which, while foundational, is sometimes treated like a forgotten gem. A proud sponsor of this 12th staging, the Suncoast Beach Club is a resort-inspired gated community being developed on the suburban gateway to the parish of St. Thomas. The community includes a mix of residential options to suit varying lifestyle needs, ranging from townhomes and duplexes to villas and condominiums. In addition to its mix of housing types, Suncoast Beach Club comprises a commercial center and a wide array of premium amenities, all within 12 miles of the Kingston and St. Andrew metropolitan area. We encourage you for further details regarding email or website to check out the ad on the closing page of the e-zine, Art of Life magazine, the electronic edition, to which many of you, I'm sure, should already have links, or simply Google Suncoast Beach Club. We at Suncoast Beach Club are honored to be associated with the development and promotion of two iconic brands, one being the parish of St. Thomas, and the other being this poetry celebration, which is an important flag bearer for the art form and the creative arts in general. We commend Yasser Safari and his outstanding team for curating and bringing to us this first class presentation of the arts. And we join you, a quiet energetic audience, I must say. As we look forward to enjoying the rest of what is in store this evening. Thank you, and one love.
And thank you again, sir, for your continued, what's the word now? So you were listening. Your continued support of this great, great event. All right, so we're on to our second half. The first half of the program, we had the Poet Laureate of Toronto and Canada, George Elliot Clarke. We had Professor Mervyn Morris. And we had the 2022 Jamaica Poetry Festival Lifetime Achievement Awardee, Marjorie Whylie. So to kick off the second segment, we'll be a man of science and a man of the arts. Let's welcome Dr. Michael Abrams to the stage.
Good evening, everybody. You mind if I shift this thing, because I got to talk some things and I don't want anything to block it. Greetings. I don't know any sign language. The only sign language I know, I can't do it here. Right? They kick me out. So before I start, I want to do a brief survey. Let me hear it from all the laborites in the audience. Laborites, make some noise. Let me hear it from all the comrades in the audience. Come and make some noise. All right. Me tired of the tour, you know. Hear what me I say now. Every government we come in say them a fight corruption, but there is no interruption. Every government we come in say them a fight corruption, but there is no interruption. The primary problem come into secondary color. But no matter which are the two of them end up in our power, we see Sam Fire, Nancy and Bandulu. For corruption stick on them like tattoo. Thief money and no wash no face. Crony is the money place. Taxpayer money waste. Mix up scandal and disgrace. Then the upper position, then turn up trunk, kick up rumpus and said that it's wrong. But when them get elect and them come in, them same one come down and go do the same thing. Every government we come in say them a fight corruption, but there is no interruption. Every government we come in say them a fight corruption, but there is no interruption. We need some heroes. For we're tired and vexed and broken-hearted, our tropical paradise long departed. Turn rudderless ship, I see it in a tsunami. Need some hero to steer the vessel and calm we. For somehow we are jump overboard while we can and freestyle we way to safe and dry land. We need powerful leaders. Too many bottom feeders. Parasites and predators among ministers and senators. For we reach rock bottom and it's like we can't go no lower. Feel like grass under mower. For as we see little sun, we get cut down by corruption and greed as the craven feed. Until us fit do without, while them stuff fit them out. And we take the crumbs them left for us after them nam till them belly warm boss. We need some heroes. Hero who will bear them chests and afraid to take lick in at them left breast. Champions of veracity, not pathological mendacity. Who will step away from the crowd and call the things them loud and forget about party and orange and green, for the two of them are the same thing. Know what I mean? Forget about rituals and tradition and afraid to go against party position and fight for what then was right, and stop trying to hold on to them status tight and put our needs before theirs as they manage our affairs, cause hey, hero know what them sacrifice. And some people will think say them not nice, but for the greater good of the land, them will take a stand and put aside personal gain and share Someone with pain, yo. We need some heroes. Heroes who will stand up for the youth. Because to tell you the truth, they're in a bad way, and they're lost. They need direction, guidance, and protection, and this must be done at all costs. Because from them pan breast and from them a toddler, them see few good role model, but holy pa magla. Roughneck sketchel and worthless sample. In the public eye, I said bad example. Dishonest and weak leaders who sit upon the fence and rock rules and laws with no consequences. Those with integrity in positions of authority now appear to be fading into the minority. While kids cry for absent fathers and mothers who care. Less about them pick me and more about false here. We need some heroes for a youth to emulate before it's too late and then go up and perpetuate this failing state, this cycle of hostility, mediocrity, and negativity. Cause me downward spiral is like a video gone viral out of a black hole as we approach the black hole. Yes, we need some heroes. We need some heroes. We need some heroes. Any politicians in the audience tonight? Thank God. Before I go any further, I want to just express some gratitude. Gratitude. Firstly, to Yasso Safari. Is Yasso here? Yasso, where are they? Yasso. Is Yasso in? Anyway, I want to big up Yasso Safari for what he has done for poetry in this country. For keeping poetry alive in this country. Jamaica Poetry Festival, Poetry in Motion, the Comedy Show. But I just want to express gratitude for Yasso, for his presence in this country, and gratitude to Yasso for not leaving me out and keeping me involved in these nice things. Gratitude to Professor Morris for all the poetry you've shared with us and for always being nice to me, always encouraging me. Even when you know me, I chat foolishness. You always encourage me. I love that. I appreciate you. And I appreciate Miss Whylie. Because as a little boy, I used to hear up and ring ding. I'm a big gray back, car steering, menopausal man, and she's still a play. Pick up yourself. It's an honor to share the stage with these legendary Jamaicans. And I love Jamaica a lot. But there is a lot about Jamaica I don't love. It makes sense to you? Like one of the things I don't love is the violence. The violence that reach me. Like any kind of violence you can think about Jamaica, holy by it. Gang violence, gender-based violence, domestic violence, intimate partner violence. And the thing about intimate partner violence is it rough when the person you were supposed to run to, you end up a run from. And it affects both genders. But women tend to bear the brunt of it. So ladies, I have some advice for you. If you see a red flag, run. Nobody stand up and try to decide or figure out which way the flag will wave or what shade of red the flag is. Just run. This one is called This Can Work. The last thing that she said to me was, I know that this can work. And I said to her, I can't believe you're going back to that jerk. Him abuse you till you almost lose you, take your money and use you. Then him turn around and refuse you. And every time you go back, him not stop, but abuse you. So don't expect me to jump for joy and dance and King Papa Lick. Because ever since you and that man there, you have been his beating stick. And don't expect me to join you upon your roller coaster ride, for it hurt enough just to sit and watch the dysfunction from outside. Behind our back, her hypocrite friend them, don't stop dead with laugh. Because every minute she and the man would fall out and kick off, the relationship was rocky. It was very helter-skelter. And every now and then, she would run to her friends for physical and emotional shelter. So when she said she was going back, me said to her, baby, make me backtrack. Wasn't this the guy who did blood up your face and smear your good name all over the place? Your life was full of acrimony and friction, but you're still caught up in your abuse addiction. One more hit, just one more fix. You know you're going back there to get more licks. She said she was going back because of all of the changes him did make. But that's the same thing she did say last year, just before him did wring her neck. And she tell me how she loved him and this was meant to be. But that's what she did say a few years back. And then him go douse her with hot tea. So I'm sitting in the church and I'm looking at my watch and it's now 12:45. And I'm wondering if there's anything else that I could have done to take her out of the situation. Though God knows me, they tried on several occasions. The ball on the place when them sing Amazing Grace. And I remember how when I met her, she had such a pretty face. But that was long before the infamous incident in the car. When he did back out the ratchet and gave her that big, long, ugly scar. The autopsy report said the acid reached her lungs and burned her flesh right down to the bone. The police him dashed upon her after an argument over a message upon her cell phone. She did give her brother a gift and him tell her thanks and how him love her in a text. But the idiot read it and says her lover and that he was thanking her for sex. Some people say there's a very thin line between being in love and being stupid. Is it a blow to the head by a 2x4 or an arrow to the heart from Cupid? Some victims will tell us they are committed to the cause while we shake our heads and hold our jaws. But when you start to wear bandage and gauze, it's time to step back and take a permanent pause. Respect. I love women. I look after women for a living. I love them. Gentlemen, treat women good here. Love them up. Love them up. But I have some advice for the man them too. You see, if you meet a woman, a new woman, and things are go a certain way, I head towards certain things. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? You're not talking about? You don't know what you're talking about? It's a head to a certain direction, man. You know, things are going and things. I have some advice for you. Don't run up your mouth, yeah? Don't do it. Because sometimes some weird things can happen, yeah? This one name, you don't know. You don't know, you see me? Now I mean? Oh, now I buck up this young girl from my day. Come in on my yard and I go on the most way. I hype up herself and a rare and a tear. But you don't know me as a youth, we don't lay. So I say, yo, my girl, why you act so flirty? And I been over your little body like, say, you want to give me 6:30. And so me thinky. And I'm pion. And I try to disrespect me. But you don't know, say, so you can't. For me, are the original international ladies, man, have more woman than smoke particle in the ear over river tan. For real, my thing shot, it turn up till it buck. So come here now, my girl, and make me give you a good time. Yes, me know that never rhyme. But whether digicel or lime, me I go give you some proper credit. And open your body, me I go send it. You don't know, you see me, know what I mean? Oh, you don't know, you see me? Know what I mean? Ooh. Then me say to her, I say, pray me good, my girl. Look for me, oh, me dapper. You don't know me at the original bedroom bully show stopper. When it come to the art of dogo dogo, me a tapa tapa shatter. And for me shot them sting hotter than hollow point or copper. Hey, so much woman out there, say, I me them one fi have. That if them farm a line, it would have stretched from Maran Bay to Save. For me mattress, for me bed, see so much woman traffic, that them all write story about me in the National Geographic. So now take me fin a little dibby dibby full of loops. As a matter of fact, tonight, me only go give you a little tops. For if me give you the full 100, you head me at a ticket for true. And you start walk street and talk to yourself and end up at Bellevue. You don't know, you see me? Know what I mean? Oh, you don't know. You see me? Know what I mean? Oh, So me shove me key in ignition. I me back for me mission. I me whisper in her ear. I me make me intention very clear. Say tonight me a go make the Kama Sutra come in like a little flyer. Cause all the things set up, me go take her to her levels as higher and give her all that she require. We set her body on fire and satisfy her desire and take her down to the wire. And as me step on the accelerator and start to shift me gear stick. She fling in a little movement, so me never expect, and me kind of done too quick. She no come round my yard again. And she walk street and tell the world her friend, say me pop down and me workless and me can't do nothing, I'm soft. But me was a done the place for a few seconds still, until me did pop off. You don't know. Isn't me? Know what I mean? Ooh. Good night. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Big up yourself, Dr. Abrams. All right, that was Dr. Michael Abrams, a man who has successfully married science and the creative arts. We'll now be having a deaf poetry by Marissa Phillips from the Jamaica Association for the Deaf. I'm gonna need some help to get that done.
Poem by Miss Louise Bennett Coverley. No little twang. Me glad to see you come back, boy, but Lord, you let me down. Me shame are you till all of me proudest drop a groan. You mean you go there, you go to America and spend 6 whole months there and come back not a piece better? Then how do you did go away? Boy, you no shame. It's so you come after your tan so long. Not even little language, boy, not even little twang. And your sister worked that uncle 1 week with American. She talks so nice, no till we have the juicy understand. Boy, you couldn't improve yourself and you get so much pay. You spend 6 months a foreign and come back ugly same way. Not even a draper's trousers are a past the rhythm coat. Boy, not even a gold teeth or a gold chain round your throat. Suppose me last me pass go introduce. You to a stranger as me lamented son what lately come from America. Them would have laughed after me, boy. Me couldn't tell them so. Them would have said me lie you was a spend time back a moko. No back answer me boy, you talk too bad. Shut up your mouth. And don't know how you are, you and your pupa going to make it out. If you want to please him, make him think you bring back something new. You always call him pa. This evening, when him come, say, poo.
What kind of finky-finky clap that? Clap the lady. That's what you call poetry in language and motion. Like I could feel, you know? I could feel the words. All right, we're going to have another presentation coming right up.
With you in person at this wonderful event. Sad not to be there. But I want to talk about this thing called art. Art encompasses music, dance, literature, these ways of expressing ourselves at best when they come from inspiration and from our hearts. And poetry is just one of those important avenues of expression. And I want to say that in my case, when I play my piano notes, I'm thinking as poetically as possible, because this is how you express yourself. So it's not the lyric and the words, it's the notes of music. And I identify with events that, as we say in Jamaica, big up the art form of poetry. So I myself was not very good in school with the poetry and all these other aspects, dancing and such, but music was my heartstring. That's where I fell into it. And the thing that happened for me because of this gift, it helped me to have a decent life where boredom and idleness didn't enter into my situation, because this is what will help the young person be inspired with the life that they're having, to create words, to write words for a song, or just beautiful poetic words to express ourselves. So I'm here to applaud and encourage people to seek the expression of poetic words. It's a wonderful thing, whether it's music, but in this case we're talking about poetry. And in fact, specifically, that comes from our Jamaican culture, because the way to speak the word in Jamaica is like nowhere else in the world. It is totally unique. Totally unique. When you say words of Jamaican, what we handed down to us in the heritage, you feel happy. You say something and it bring more of a spring in your step. So I believe very strongly that poetry, especially coming from yard, we are expressing ourselves, is very, very important to having a good life, a more wonderful life, a more inspired life. So I applaud those at this event, at this poetry festival, the 12th year of it. I applaud you and encourage you to keep expressing yourself in this wonderful way. Thank you very much. And by the way, at this time, I myself found a new way to express myself. I have made so many albums of piano performance, sometimes live concerts, but a lot of albums, over 75, believe it or not. But this time around, on my latest release, which will be coming out very soon in a few days, August the 19th, I'm going to hold it up. The album is called Love Notes. Love Notes, because the songs all relate to the aspect of love. Loving one another, loving the beautiful girl you're with, the girl loving the nice guy you're with. And it's love songs, the kind of music you would have heard when our parents, our grandparents would be dancing with each other. So I did these songs, and among the songs is one that is a nice video with me and a beautiful lady, and we're singing and dancing and the whole thing. So check it out. It's called As Time Goes By. It came from that classic film of the late 40s called Casablanca. So Monty Alexander, I'll sing a little tune. I hope you check it out. I hope you like it. And big up Poetry Festival in a massive way. Thank you for listening to my words. One love.
Is still a kiss. A sigh is just a sigh. The fundamental things apply as time goes by. And when two lovers woo, they still say, I love you. On that you can rely. No matter what the future brings, as time goes by. Moonlight and love songs, never out of date. Hearts full of passion, jealousy and hate. Woman needs man, and man must have his mate. That no one can deny. It's still the same old story, a fight for love and glory. A case of do or die. The world will always welcome lovers as time goes by. Passion, jealousy and hate. Woman needs man, and man must have his mate. That no one can deny. It's still the same old story, a fight for love and glory, a case of do or die. Always. Well.
ladies and gentlemen, Monty Alexander. He's recognized as one of the greatest jazz and blues pianists in the world. And he is a son of the soil. I spoke to him recently and he told me he's from East Kingston and he has spent his entire life dedicated to this form of art. Next to grace the stage is a dub poet, author, and ambassador, a man who has been one of the artists at the forefront of the effort for social intervention, renewal, and transformation through the application of edutainment. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome the chief ideator of Jamaica Poetry Festival, Yasso Safari.
Observation, inspiration, meditation. Charge with vibration, climax reaching orgasm. I pen mechanism is ejaculating, and I see men flowing from my pen. I pen. Warriors of humanity, enemies of outer equity, champions of right, children of light, fighting against evil, Satan, the devil. Soldiers of the army, destroying apartheid and poverty, establishing free man, free woman, equality and liberty. My tongue is the pen of a red writer, writing upon the winds of time. My mind rests upon the fleshy pages of my heart. My eyes, the mirror of yesterday, today, and tomorrow. I'm seeking divinity, propagating my thoughts by the powers of telepathy, giving thanks and praises unto the Most High, His Imperial Majesty, Emperor Haile Selassie, Jah, Rastafari, as I see men, women, and children flowing from I pen, mightier than the sword, every time. We are a part of the environment. So issues of poverty, violence, and injustice are environmental issues. So we like to talk about environmental and climate justice. We are inhabitants of one planet, Earth. So think about this and journey with us. Are you ready for the music of the tongue? Earth is a garden of creation, purposefully clothed with lush green vegetation, roots firm enough to prevent critical soil erosion, all elements working in union for natural joy and satisfaction. The earth is our friend. We are the friends of the earth. The cyclic function of the Earth's ecology is no mystery. Like the organs of the human body, each working in perfect harmony in this our environmental community, of which the guardians and the keepers are the children of humanity. The Earth is our friend. We are the friends of the Earth. The rivers, like blood streams flowing into the oceans, returning secretly to the fleshy bowels of the earth's creation, evaporating to the atmospheric breath of life. Sun, moon, and stars, solid, liquid, and gas, flesh, blood, and spirit. The earth is our friend. We are the friends. Like the lungs of man, the trees breathe to keep the earth alive. Yea, the sun, like a devoted father, working from sunrise until sunset. And the moon, like a loving mother, working from dusk until dawn, shining within the sweet embrace of her children, the stars. The earth is our friend. We are the friends of the earth. If we protect the earth, then the earth will protect us, clothe, feed, and shelter us. The earth is a garden of creation. If we keep the earth alive, then we will stay alive. The earth will keep us alive. The earth is our mother and our friend. We are the friends and the children of the earth. Of the earth. Of the earth. Of Mother Earth. Take care of her, and she will take care of us. The human family need not be the human race. And we need not destroy the planet Earth, then we go camp out in a space. And sometimes I feel like aliens are among us. Or maybe I am the alien among us. So you see, I need not with them two-faced society. Witches sleeping in bed with the enemy. Yet this very same two-faced society is still in bed with the people, pretending to be lovers and friends and leaders of the people who them systematically reduce to sheep. So you see, I ain't in a nut with them two-faced society. Them hide and seek the truth, yet the truth could never be hidden. Now them promoting voluntary genocide, living dead and walking blind with them two eyes open wide, dancing upside down under the spell of we decide, but them own smell round them up, so them just can't hide, and as them slip, them dollar slide, so them destruction open wide. Well, wider and wider. So you see, I ain't nothing with them two-faced society. I still see them vampirizing the people, reducing them to feces as a conquest of war. So you see, I stay far, yet I declare war. And my life is an open book without an open scar. And if you look at my heart, it black like tar. Yes, I am that same black heart man, chief architect of the revolutionary gang, who don't do no wrong. All we do is systematically dismantled, Babylon twisted, perverted, schizo-freaking society. So you see, I don't know about you, but me not in a nothing with them two-faced, schizo-freaking society. Now, Uncle Stevie say, I can see clearly, but even Stevie wonder how this pants and shirt wrote a move so blouse and skirt crazy. Armed, mad and giddy in a dish of Amagidian. Them say, I read, but them not ready. I word sound is power. Right from Jamaica, the world's cultural superpower. Well, and maybe not anymore. Because after 60 years of independence, we can't find 10 festival songs to celebrate with 60 years of independence. But whichever way you take it, I word sound is power. Right from Jamaica, the world's farmer cultural superpower, straight to Saudi Arabia, the maker for the petrodollar, where the blood of Isla Boyle and the money get too bloody, the greed gets so thick that them think them slick, while corruption a dance upon them face, caress them cheek, and kiss off all them bloody lip. In a dis-democratic dictatorship. Neuro-linguistic programming, psychological conditioning, false menu them serving, I know them not pay for them food, yet them still a tip. Blood money at the tip of a whip, and the devil is the captain of them ship in a dis-democratic dictatorship. Bloody police disturbing the peace with the mark of the beast, and the bloody soldier never know ja, but them thinks of them soldier. So them sell them soul for silver and gold and blood money. And if them could, them would, because them think them soldier. Servants and slaves of Bakramasa. Them armed to them teeth, but them still not ready. And as the pendulum swing, watch it on social media. Tick, tock, goes the clock. And up to the lip, the cup slip, and his pure blood a drip. And the people them a ball, and the blood still a run, bloody tears them a drip. Drip, 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 drip. In this blood-sucking democratic dictatorship. Let's celebrate the music of the tongue. African redemption. Full time for reparation. We not left for repatriation. Mama Africa, me love you. Ethiopia, me need you. Yeah, yeah. Mama Africa, me love you. Ethiopia, me need you. And from ancient time, them teeth me fan you. Spread pale lion rumor pan you. Trying them best for me neglect you. But no matter what them do, me not forget you. Right now, me say me long for see you. And when me come forward, me not go left you again. Me and me wife and me children them. Mama Africa, me love you. Yeah, yeah. Ethiopia, me need you. Mama Africa, we love you. Ethiopia, me need you. And Mama Africa, give birth to humanity. And Ethiopia, suckle the whole away. And Mama Africa, give birth to humanity. And Ethiopia, suckle the whole away. Mama Africa, me love you. Ethiopia, me need you. Mama Africa, me love you. Ethiopia, me need you. Mama Africa, me love you. Ethiopia, me need you. Mama Africa, me love you.
Now, me are one of the man them believes that the woman was here on the earth before the man. Because up to now, we don't see nobody born from nobody ribs all now. So for all the ladies in the house, this is you. Thanks for what you have been doing for our country, our families, our humanity. Keep on doing what you're doing. We as the men have to step up and support you, because you are the front bone, the backbone, the side bone, the central bone, and the wishing bone. Woman, I love you. You know me really need you. Me love you, you know, say me honor you. Woman, I love you. You know me really need you. Me love you, me must I forget you. The first time me set fi me eye pan you, me heart start beat that me not know where fi do. So me take me time and me think about you. Use me mind scrutinize you. Me heart and me soul just embrace you. Me find out say you full of inner beauty. Enough in me hand you put your innocency. You make me little heart feel glad and happy. Woman, I love you. You know me really need you. Me love you, you know, say me honor you. Woman, I love you. You know me really need you. Me love you, me have a man chul you. But you know, can't go and woman chul me. Woman, I love you. You know me need you. Me love you, you know, say me honor you. Woman, I... You know me really need you. Me love you, me must not forget you. Come make we join with life together. Increase the good temperature. A raging fire is the heart desire. Come make we celebrate and procreate. Humble we self and live in a faith. Cause when me put it on, everything is great. To man, I love you. You know me really need you. Me love. You know, say me honor you. Woman, I love you.
you know me really need you. Me love you, you know, so me honor you. Look how we captain the ship name relationship. One sip, two dip, me heart start skip. Two sip, three dip, me sight a eclipse, especially when me kiss your tender lips. So man, I love you, you know me really need you. Me love you, you know, so me honor you. Woman, I love you. You know, me really need you. Me love you, me happy man, truly. Me are the man, and you are the woman. And me are the prince, and you are princess. And me are the sun, and you are the moon. One come late, and the other come soon. Listen to me heart, and dance to the tune. Together, make we set up a global plan, heart to heart and hand in hand, trudging straight up to Mount Zion. So listen to me plan and catch me intention. Woman, I love you. Need you? Love you. Honor you? Woman, I love you. Need you? Love you, may have a man, Julio. Why may I tell you, I am the rose amongst the thorns. Switch it up. Okay, we're going to do a little juggling because we want to teach them that every song is a poem set to music. Need I repeat that? By definition, every song is a poem set to music. So poetry represents the tree of life, embracing all the expressions in the creative spectrum. You think in the language that you speak, and the language that you speak shape and dictate your thinking. So we won't be victims of neuro-linguistic sorcery. We shall bring neuro-linguistic healing. Let's hear we say together after three. We love you, Miss Lou. One, two, three. We love you, Miss Lou. Oi! Oi de! You man a uno same one we a chat to. No Jamaica, a Miss Lou a the mumma fi patwa, and a she would have to tell you no, who are the pupa? Pop Catherine yasa. Patwa talking, patwa talking, patwa talking is the in. Ting, patwa talking, patwa talking, patwa talking a hit a carry swing. No, Miss Lou, when you forget the Governor General, there's the pops on lingua power with islands, so that the whole wide world could have been most understanding. But on all of the situation, you know, so Patois is the language of the forefather that was taken away from the land of Africa. So now, big up the boy named Bakramasa, for if you this culture, you curry fever in the Patois talking, Patois talk. Patois talking is the in. Patois talking, Patois talk. Patois talking, a hit a carry. Now, Mr. Golden and Andrew Honus may be going to chat patwa so that the poor people them can understand, yeah, sir. For some good rogue, when I use multi boss, me ears drop, make me head a spin like me under white room in the House of Parliament, or that is my argument. And when you read the budget with inner dialect, and by the time you did about a worry and fret, 100 members say we export patwa yet. So if you manufacture it and export it like a jet in the patwa talking, patwa talk. Patwa talking is the in. Patwa talking, patwa talking, patwa talking, a hit a carry. Now some people hide it tighty and speak his spoken and play a cockatoo and take liberty and want to downgrade the vocabulary. But if a man shot them a box and land them two kick, or if them borrow my friend Muta Baruka foot and Maka took them in a hit, whoa, Maka took me! Oh no, hear how they land, how featured patwa quick in a day. Patwa talking, patwa talking, patwa talking is the end. Patwa talking, patwa talk. Patwa talking, a hit a carry. Bless it and set it. Two quick snippets. We won't balkanize Jamaica. We call in on the Maroons, the Rastafari, the Revivalists, the Kumina, the Muslim, the Christians, the Atheists. Let's come together. and build our country. Plain and simple. Uno can violate for me temper. Make me tell you that plain and simple. Uno na go violate for me temper. Make me tell you that plain and simple. You could have stood till you're blue and wrinkle, or smile till you smile for your temper. Uno na violate for me temper. Make me tell you that plain and simple. Uno can violate for me temper. Hold on there, let me make a pause. Micaiah affectionately called Mick. When I put you on the spot, but you are the heart that beats outside my chest. You are my inspiration. You are my strength. You are my motivation. You are a part of this song. You inspired it. And this one is for you, as we touch a little bit piece more of it, dedicated to my daughter, 10 years young, Micaiah. Uno can violate for me temper. Make me tell you that plain and simple. Uno no fi violate uno temper. Make me tell you that plain and simple. Me na go violate for your temper. Make me tell you that plain and simple. Uno can violate for your temper. Make me tell you that plain and simple. You could have screwed till you blue and wrinkle, or smile till you smile for your dimple. Uno can violate for your temper. Make me tell you that. Make me tell you that. Make me tell you that. Make me tell you that plain and simple. Thank you. Maroon, maroon with the golden spoon. Maroon, maroon with the golden spoon. We all soon need you, maroon. We all are gonna need you, maroon. Maroon, maroon with the golden spoon. Maroon, maroon with the golden spoon. We all soon need you, maroon. We all are gonna need you, maroon. Some of them are laugh and I take it for a joke. Couldn't better stop nyam poor me happy tell you not the truth. Pork at the family of rose breadfruit. Black outside and white inside. Some of them are dodge and some of them are hide. Some are blind, they be shooting at the great river Clyde. So them sit, so them slide. Look how them collide. Them fall out of love through them in a false pride. Maroon, maroon with the golden spoon. Maroon, maroon.
We also need you, maroon. We all are gonna need you, maroon.
Let's hear it for them. They are the harmonizers on this song. Marcia Bedrock and the Isis Princess. Let me hear just a little bit as we go out with it. Maroon, maroon with the golden spoon.
Maroon, maroon
with the golden spoon.
We all so need you, maroon. We all are gonna need you, maroon.
Maroon, maroon with the golden spoon. Maroon, maroon with the golden spoon. We all so need you, maroon. We all are gonna need you, maroon. We all so need you, maroon. Love you. Jamaica Poetry Festival, AC Marriott, 2022. See you on the 13th of August, our 13th anniversary. 13th of August, 2023. Honor, love, and prosperity. Bless it and set it.
He took us from topic to topic, the very definition of edutainment. We got a little bit of social commentary. We got to hear about the effects of climate change. We got to hear about some man and woman story. We got to hear a little bit about history. Yasa Safari. Up next, we have Skip Marley. He is the 2022 Youth Ambassador for the Jamaica Poetry Festival. We're going to be hearing him on the screen.
Yo, this is Skip Marley, Jamaica youths. Don't give up the fight. Together they can break us, we are strong. See? Yeah. Each one teach one, you know? Each one help the next one. So forth and so forth. You know what I mean? Yeah, man. No matter what they do, you know, we keep on coming through. She wanna spend some time into the light, into the light. She wanna catch a vibe, she wanna free her mind into the light, into the light. Fancy, she don't want nothing basic. She want to touch all bases, build up relations, rev up the car and race it. Catch vibrations, oh, she want release and mental. Catch all the nerve that's central. Switch on the beat and tempo. Inside of her bare info. Zell nor Venmo, just let go, oh. Just let go for me. Let go for me, oh. Just let go, oh. Just let go for me. Let go for me. She wanna catch a vibe, she wanna spend some time into the light, into the light. She wanna catch a vibe, she wanna free her mind into the light, into the light. Whoa, yeah, yeah. Whoa, yeah. Whoa, yeah, yeah. Whoa, yeah. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Just let go for me. Let go for me, hey. Just let go for me. Let go for me. She wanna catch a vibe, she wanna spend some time into the light, into the light. She wanna catch a vibe, she wanna free her mind into the light, into the light, to the light. She don't want nothing basic. She want to touch one basis. Build up relation, rev up the car and race it. Vibration, she want release that mental. Catch all that herb that's central. Switch on the beat and tempo. Inside the herb bear info. Mrs. L nor Venmo, just let go, oh. Just let go for me. Let go for me. Just let go, oh. Just let go for me. Let go for me. She catch the vibe. She wanna spend the time into the light, into the light. She wanna catch a vibe. She wanna free her mind into the light, into the light. Thank you.
catch a vibe, she wanna spend some time into the light. Free of mind.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was Grammy-nominated artist and grandson of the great Bob Marley, Mr. Skip Marley. Thank you very much for, you know, gracing our screens with your, what did Yassas call it? Poem turned into music? Yes, that's what he called it. All right, so coming up next is a woman who once said, when life gives you back talk, don't be afraid to talk back. JPF, let's welcome Ebony Payne.
Peace and blessings. When I give things to the universe, it is gracious enough to return them. So peace and blessings, Jamaica. Ashe. My name is Ebony Payne English. I bring you greetings from Jacksonville, Florida. And I'm going to share some poetry. Before I exchange with an audience, it is customary for us to get on the same energetic level by sharing some affirmations. So if you could repeat after me, I am whole and complete. I am divinely capable. Life is blessed by my presence. And I am present. And I am ready. And I am willing. Amen, Ashe.
The fool has said in his heart, there is no God. For every passionate, prolific point that proceeds from my pen, for every bountifully brilliant, beautiful brushstroke by an artist's hand, for every soulfully soothing sound sensationally sang, for every masterfully melodic, momentous symphony ever played, for every catharsis, captivatingly choreographed ballet insists that God exists. In this, and gifts of creative expression, laws of the universe we intuit, we capture time via sheet music, measure greatness in plié, defy the grave on stage, staining canvas is our way of getting the God out. It shouts from our soul, too thunderous to control. It holds our mouth and limbs proxy to stop the nothing from consuming us all. As artists, we have been called. Were born, rather, with a God complex, causing us to manifest miraculous montages to the macrocosm, causing effective reflective thought and collective observers who've heard or eyewitnessed a sentence performer, judged as a zygote to be heaven's ode to imagination, authors of creations outlasting ancient civilizations, serving as our calibrations on this earth. We birth permanent footprints, remnants of the God in me. Mortality is no place for an artist to be. Eternity suits our fancy. So hand in hand we travel across the galactic span of time as divine beings, never seeing the last chapter. We've mastered the fountain of youth. As creators, it's our nature to interpret the truth, to express our best, our worst. What heals, what hurts, the universe gave me infinity with my introduction to this ink, and we shall scribble on for centuries, like Marcus Garvey's indestructible vocabulary, or Albert Huey's invincible hues, Bob Marley's unconquerable blues, or Alfonso's bulletproof patent leather dancing shoes. Life is the most precious thing given you. So we imitate the present, conveying the lessons we've learned. In return, we earn death's refusal, God's approval. The knowledge of these things delivers me hopeful. I create myself immortal. So when I say back talk, y'all say talk back, back talk. Back talk. They will push you over the edge. Lie in wait for you to fall like prey into statistical references that perpetuate institutional preferences for minority males. The sliding scale is a slippery slope you won't get a chance to remount. They will discount your intelligence, pay your accomplishments no mind until you define yourself for yourself. You'll be crunched into other people's fantasies of yourself and eaten alive. Audrey tried to warn us as best she could. The cannibals are coming in search of fresh blood, and they will beat you fair and square. You see, black people in boxes is part of the regime's pedagogical alignment, whether it's caskets or solitary confinement. Now, where has the time went? To maximum sentences for first-time offenses, this is survival. One of the oldest stories told in the Bible, you are not a citizen. Cain has disabled your membership. The state of Iowa is 89% Caucasian. For every one white male, there are 8 black men in incarceration, and they say the United States is the world's greatest nation. Our president supports prison privatization. It aided in stimulating our economy, did wonders for Wall Street. But they keep that on the hush, and we walk around in designer earplugs, beaten by Bray. Every derogatory word they spray over the airwaves is a paid advertisement for Prison Bronx Express. And at blind consumption, we seem to be the best, still stressed, oppressed, and under duress. But they haven't even changed the game up, haven't even changed the name. Still using whips and chains to maintain our compliance. I feel so defiant when I pull up to a gig all clean. So I twerk until it hurts. I shake it fast as if I were auditioning for the Sarah Bartman Circus Act. Now who is that? These are questions best asked on Google. I live in a state where parents of murdered children still peacefully march for justice's sake. But today we will face some facts. Peaceful marches are not what passed the Civil Rights Act. It was the inhumanity the media was able to display on the global stage that made segregation bad for foreign relations, and the United States does not tolerate any interference with business or image. The thing with the fire hoses and German shepherds made us lepers at the UN and put tension in trade agreements, and you may deem this bitter banter. But George Zimmerman was not arrested until they brought in the cameras, because they never loved us. Remember? They used to never want to hear us, but we trust them to educate our youth. For our scholars like Henry Louis Gates, Cornel West, and Maya Angelou to teach at Ivy League schools, alumni of HBCUs graduate and turn their backs. Nasir Jones gave a hip-hop fellowship to Harvard University of the student populace. How many do you think are black? And they want to tell me it's progress, but somehow it feels we've lost our minds. There's an innate and cultivated hate for ourselves and our own kind. And before we disagree, there's this term, black on black crime, and the effortless matriculation of our neighborhood's decline. They continue to feed all babies corn syrup and swine, knowing it causes diabetes. They stand idly by while the pharmaceutical industry makes a killing off killing. We medicated mockeries of our forgotten history. Oh, what clueless lives we lead, continuously feeding frivolously of fictional saviors that have long lost their savor. A mirage enchanted pupil, dilated with narcotic fallacies, unscrupulous deeds, destructive by nature, a miseducated population on our very worst behavior. Ashe. Thank you. So, Marcus Garvey is a personal hero of mine. And this is my first time in Jamaica, so it does mean a lot to me. It is such a beautiful country, and y'all are such beautiful people. You have such a wonderful spirit about you, and the light is spread internationally. There's not a place in the world that Jamaica has not touched or influenced or impacted. And that is something to be very, very proud of. Happy 60th independence. Happy 12th anniversary Jamaica Poetry Festival.
And thank you so much for the opportunity. This is going to be my last poem. It is called Whole and Complete. And Oroko mi ye ye, Oroko mi jesha, Oroko mi ye ye, Oroko mi jesha. Wati ba un soroko, ye ye olude, ye ye olude, basi basim ba un soroko, ye ye pamelude, ye ye pamelude akara. Ye ye pamelude, ye ye pamelude akara. I'm the mama who tried to warn you there'd be days like this. The prophetess and the myth, the messenger and message. I am a blessing, therefore I am blessed. I am what became of my ancestors' reign and descent. I was never meant to survive it. Nevertheless, here I am thriving. I am alive and well. I am healing myself, forgiving missteps. I am drifting a little farther and loving a little harder. I am safe harbor for the harbored resentment against the misfits and outcasts. Cast your cares upon me. Confront me with all of your corrective suggestions I'm collecting to hang on the wall of my studio sessions, each one a lesson on just how mistaken you must be to attempt control of the queen. I am the land of the free. On my feet, despite my scars, my unbarred bars are unabashed by the brash things you say to state trooper my parade. I am still afloat, although they turn black folks to ghosts every day. I am unfazed by the demons of yesterday. I am today and forever. I am the ever-glowing muse of the creator. I am more than skin deep. I've no Emmy. But the world in my hands is not a challenge. I am balanced enough to congratulate true talent and evaluate the talents who pick apart my gifts. I am the A-list, authentic, audacious, atomic. I'm the bomb diggity, erotic, bionic, like Babs somewhere in the lab cooking up substance. I am sustenance. Feast your eyes upon me whole. I am the soul outside your window. I am chocolate-covered sunshine. I am divine intervention. I am mission accomplished. I am monument to the struggle. Still spined in my hustle, I am trouble. The good kind. I am the unkilled revolution. I am Fred Hampton's dying wish. I am the fish in the sea that stands alone amongst plenty. I am empty for tolerance for the thievery and foolishness. I am a movement by myself. I am determined to make me better. I am the letter N, Nico Lent to the Arlington Expressway. I am Easter Sunday. I am rose and thorn. It is as though I was born with a purpose that is larger than life. I am fair fight. I am the caged bird's plight. I am a freedom song, awakening the memories of home. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Ebony, the bomb diggity that graced our stage. Thank you so much. I was feeling that last one. That last one, I was really feeling. I am the chocolate-covered sunshine. Yes, I am. All right, coming to grace the stage is Mr. Mark Stephenson. He is going to be gracing us with a creative and innovative piece, Reggae Violin.
Good evening, everybody. I'll be playing a couple songs for you. Hope you enjoy it. Give it a
musical chess.
Run a track. I guess it's...
Thank you.
Jamaica now.
Thank you.
you.
Is the recipient of the JPF 2022 International Youth Ambassador Award. Presenting the award is Sheree Johnson. Receiving the award on his behalf is Mr. Norman Bryan. Seems Mr. Bryan is unavailable at the moment, so we'll move on. We have a few awards for our sponsors. We ask Mr. Mervyn Johnson to come and collect the award on behalf of the AC Marriott Hotel, who were our gracious hosts. Demonstrated and the level of support received. We ask Miss Marjorie Thomas to come and collect the award on behalf of the PBCJ. All right. Thank you, Miss Thomas. And with that, we end the 12th staging of the Jamaica Poetry Festival. We want to thank our sponsors, AC Marriott Hotel in Kingston, PBC Jamaica, Digicel Foundation, JN Group, Tourism Enhancement Fund, the Jamaica Tourist Board, Proven, Suncoast Beach Club, TCF Holdings, and Senyacom Edutainment. Also, special thank you to Tamia Carey Collections for my outfit. And of course, my exquisite jewelry pieces came from OMG Jewelers. I also want to give a special shout out to my stylist from Alicia Creatives, Alicia Steele, who helped to put all of these looks that I've been presenting together. See you at the next Poetry Festival. Okay. This audience, I tell you, they're very engaging, you know, they're here and present. Wait. So, yes, the gate prize.
We'll be giving some information about the gatebook, but can I just finish talking about my sponsors first, the people who, you know, make sure that the gate prize is happening. Can I just give me a second? Okay. So, we'd like to invite you to the Poetry in Motion 20th anniversary. It's Sunday, February 26th, 2023. It will be at the Manchester Golf Club in Mandeville, and the Jamaica Poetry Festival 2023 is already set. It's Sunday, August 13th, 2023, our 13th anniversary. So get your tickets early. All right, so from the entire production team, it was a pleasure spending the evening with you good people. It's been very engaging. All right, good night, everyone. All right. We're closing out the event, so I'm going to be finding out who is the lucky guest that won the special prize. Wait, no. You want to bring it up here, sir? All right. It's coming. Hold on. Wait. You see, like how my good another person to hope I am the guest number two, you know. I must be your plus, what them call it? Plus one. I hope me is the plus one. Calm down, before we get to it, I'm being told that someone has lost their wallet, so they're asking kindly, while you're here, just look to your right side. Alright, you see it? Anybody see it? Alright, look to your left side. You see it? Alright, look under it if you can, Ben. Alright, if you're walking out and you so happen to see a wallet, please bring it to the front desk so that that person can receive their wallet. It's very annoying to lose your wallet. Okay, so we're gonna get to the good part. All right, so I'm going to give it a good shake. This is the box that has, you know, that lucky. Turn it. No, but. Okay, so this lady over here is saying hers would be on the bottom because she came early. So, all right. Okay. All right now, miss? Okay, over this side? All right. The lucky holder, everybody have their stubs out? All right, you have a three? Check if you have the three, you know. You have the two? Okay. So, Shagun, didn't have the three? I am so sorry. But I'll see you next year, August 13th. Yeah, we see you. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Come back again. Better luck next time. One whole year. All right. So you have the three. Wait, I can't see what. Six. So we have three and six so far. You're going? Good night. And no. But what good? They're all in it. Wait. All right, so we'll have a three and a six. And the next number. No, but you have to quiet, you know. The lucky person for a weekend for two at Sandals, including Simone Gale. 368. If you're the lucky person, my ear on squeal. Let me go again. make the lady over there so go on home. Oh, no, hold on, stop. Okay. All right. Patience is the first number one.
She still don't get it. Oh, no.
Second number six. And the third number for... No, it's a six. Yeah, it's a six. And the lucky person, oh, they're here. 164. No? All right. 0. All right, the last number, a 7. We ain't gonna get the middle number. We ain't gonna get the middle number. Come again. Lucky number 097. Yeah! Yeah! We have a winner! Aisha got carry me with her for a weekend for two. Thank you very much, everyone, for joining us this evening. God bless and walk good.
This morning.